إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. الحمد لله، we praise Allah and we seek His assistance and we seek His forgiveness. And we seek refuge in Allah from the evil within ourselves and from our bad deeds. Whoever Allah guides, there is none that can lead him astray, and whoever is led astray, then there is no guide for him. I bear witness that no God has the right to be worshipped other than Allah. He is alone and has no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and his messenger. O you who believe, fear Allah as you ought to be feared, and don't die except as Muslims. O humanity, fear your Lord who has created you from a single soul and created from it its mate and scattered from them to many men and women. And fear Allah for whom you demand your mutual rights, and don't cut off relations with the wounds that bore you. Indeed, Allah is a raqib over you. O you who believe, fear Allah and say that which is correct, in order that He may accept from you your deeds and forgive you of your sins. And whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger has achieved the greatest achievement. Amma ba'du, certainly the most truthful speech is the book of Allah. And the finest guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the most evil of affairs are newly invented matters in this deen. And every newly invented matter in this deen is a bid'ah. And every bid'ah is a string. And every string is in the fire. Brothers and sisters in Islam, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And listen to the tafsir of Surah Al-Hujurat. But before we begin, we want to mention an aspect of this community, as we do before mentioning the tafsir of this surah. We want to mention IDS, or the Islamic Day School, of which this is the fifth year of a five-year lease with the building 261 William Street. Next month, the believers will be leaving that building, walhamdulillah rabbil alameen, after we have already paid, with the exception of this month and next month, about $298,000, excluding the late fees, which makes it much more than $300,000. It's been paid, walhamdulillah rabbil alameen. And the school, inshallah, next September will be known as Madrasatu Ahl Sunnah, and it will be at 215 North Arrington Parkway, inshallah ta'ala. But as far as the losers in this community who we were referring to last week, who make the statement they won't open the school in September, we will, inshallah ta'ala, as the registration has already begun, and it will continue to the end of June at 261 William Street in Orange, inshallah. And in July, the registration will begin in the Islamic Center of America, Madrasatu Ahl Sunnah, inshallah ta'ala. What we're expecting from the people is on June the 13th, where we will hold the Jumu'ah not here, but we would hold it in Masjid Ahl Sunnah, inshallah, to bring your money to make sure that we reach at least $150,000, so that we would move into the building with ease in September, inshallah ta'ala. And the success is with Allah, and we ask Him for His success. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He tells us, wa'alamu anna fikum rasulallah. لو يطيعكم في كثير من الأمر لعنتم، ولكن الله حبب إليكم الإيمان وزينه في قلوبكم وكره إليكم الكفر والفسوق والعصيان، أولئك هم الراشدون فضلا من الله ونعمة والله عليم حكيم. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He tells us in these ayat that we were mentioning last week and before the month of Ramadan where we ended, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and know that the Messenger of Allah is amongst you, to the end of those two ayat. Last week we saw how the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was amongst us with his seerah, or the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam. And this week inshaAllah ta'ala we want to see how the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is with us with his physical description or characteristics of the last prophet and messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. If we were to bring all of the authentic narrations of the companions of the prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with their exact wording from the hadith of the prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam, it would be too long for the khutbah. So what we want to do inshallah is to summarize in brief the description of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as based on the authentic narrations that we have taken from the book of our Shaykh Muhammad ibn Rizq ibn Tarhuni al-Misri hafizahullah, and the title is An-Nabiyyu sallallahu alaihi wasallam ka'annaka tarahu, or the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as if you were looking at him. The Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, in the authentic hadith collected by Imam al-Tirmidhi rahimahullah and others in his book Ash-Shama'il al-Muhammadiyya, he narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, "Man ra'ani fil manam faqad ra'ani fa inna ash-shaytana la yatamathalu bi." The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he says, "Whoever has seen me in a dream, then indeed he has seen me, because the shaytan can't look like me." The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he informs us in this authentic hadith that it's possible to see the Messenger alayhi salatu wa sallam in a dream. And whoever sees him alayhi salatu wa sallam in a dream, then this is glad tidings of Jannah for that person, as we see in the narration of Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Man ra'ani fil manam fasayarani fil yaqadha." فَإِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَا يَتَمَثَّلُ بِي أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَعَلَى آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ وَسَلَّمْ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, whoever sees me in a dream, then he will see me while he is awake. And indeed the shaytan will not look like me, or cannot look like me. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in these authentic hadith, he shows us that it's possible to see him in a dream alayhi salatu wa sallam. And he has been seen after his death alayhi salatu wa sallam in the dream, as it's been authentically narrated on Asim ibn Qurayb, on the authority of his father rahimahullah, qal qultu li ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma ra'aytu an-nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fil manam. فقال عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنهما صفه لي قال ذكرت الحسن بن علي فشبهته به فقال ابن عباس رضي الله عنه فقد رأيته. كريب عاصم بن كريب, he narrates on his father كريب that he said, I said to Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I saw the Prophet in a dream. So Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he said, describe him to me. He said, I mentioned Al-Hasan ibn Ali ibn Abi Talib, the grandson of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Abdullah ibn Abbas said, indeed you have seen him. And this only shows that the believers have seen the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a dream, as they have seen him when he was alive alayhi salatu wa sallam. And this is the description of our Prophet and Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from authentic hadith. They say it's no one has been seen more handsome than the Prophet and Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that no one was like him before him or after him alayhi salatu wasalam, and that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said that he looked like his greatest grandfather Ibrahim Khalilullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam, he had a very nice body alayhi salatu wa salam. He wasn't fat, nor was he skinny sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He wasn't very tall, nor was he short sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But he was medium height, going towards the taller side sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. The Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam, they say that nothing, no fragrance was more sweeter than the fragrance of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam. He wasn't extremely white, nor was he very brown, but in his whiteness it was leaning towards the brownish color, and it was mixed with red alayhi salatu wasalam. The Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, he had very big joints sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and his shoulders, his elbows, knees, ankles, his joints and his fingers were huge alayhi salatu wasalam. Just as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, as the companions describe him, they said he had a very huge head sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wasallam, of which he used to wear, as it's been narrated, as he's been on the minbar sallallahu alayhi wasallam, wearing a black turban. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, his hair was extremely black, and he used to wear it sometimes at the length of his shoulders sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and sometimes he used to wear his hair at the length between his shoulders and his ears, and sometimes down to his earlobes alayhi salatu wasalam, and sometimes halfway down his ears sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wasallam. He never shaved his head alayhi salatu wasalam, except when he made his three umrahs in the month of Dhul Qa'dah, and his farewell hajj, which was his only hajj alayhi salatu wasalam. He shaved all of his hair alayhi salatu wasalam. He used to let his hair hang in the beginning, and then he parted his hair in the middle sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wasallam. He used to wear his hair, as it's been authentically narrated, in four plaits sometimes. And this is different as the Muslim youth and even some of the elders mistakenly understand, as they try to imitate the women and the kuffar making a style out of braids. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam prohibited the men from making salat in braids, and this style of braids is different than the four plaits of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wasallam. The Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, he had the most handsome and pleasant face sallallahu alayhi wasallam. His face was like the moon and the sun, and its roundness, as the companions radiallahu anhum described the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. His forehead was very wide, and it used to be very bright also alayhi salatu wasalam, of which had his eyebrows, which were thin, though they were very dense with the hair, and it was almost as if it was a straight line going across his face sallallahu alayhi wasallam, except that they didn't connect all the way, because in between them was a vein that used to show itself whenever he got angry alayhi salatu wasalam. His eyes sallallahu alayhi wasallam were very big and beautiful alayhi salatu wasalam. They were long and therewith. The blackness was very black in his eyes, and the white part of his eyes was mixed with red sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The nose of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam was long, and his nostrils were thin alayhi salatu wasalam. His cheeks were flat or smooth sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wasallam. His beard was very thick and dense alayhi salatu wasalam. Rather, it was a beautiful, magnificent beard that used to cover the upper part of his chest sallallahu alayhi wasallam, so much so that when he used to lead the salatu dhuhr and asr, and he was reciting the Quran, you would be able to see his beard moving from behind him sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wasallam. At the time of his death, there were not more than 20 strands of white hair in the beard of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, nor the hair on his head. And this is some of the characteristics of our Prophet and Messenger Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wasallam. بسم الله الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, his neck was kind of tall, or kind of long, alayhi salatu wasalam. And it was narrow between his shoulders, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, of which were very hairy shoulders, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi sahbihi wasallam. The chest and the stomach of the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, was even. His chest didn't stick out, nor did his stomach, alayhi salatu wasalam. And he had a very thin hair, or a thin line of hair coming down from his chest to his navel, alayhi salatu wasalam. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, on his back, he had the seal of prophethood, which was between his shoulders, alayhi salatu wasalam. And the Messenger of Allah, alayhi salatu wasalam, in this seal of prophethood, it was a lump of flesh, the color of his skin, filled with hair, and it was the size of a pigeon's egg. And this was the seal of the prophethood on the back of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he had wide, hairy forearms, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he had a huge, thick hand with thick fingers that weren't short, alayhi salatu wasalam. And the hand of the Prophet, alayhi salatu wasalam, it was softer than the finest silk, and it was colder than ice. And that the hand of the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, it smelt better than the finest misk. And the hand of the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, as the companions described it, it used to be like he dug it out of the place where the people who sell oils keep their oils, as this was the fragrance of the hand of the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, who when he used to shake the people's hands, he never let it go until they let his hand go, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The Messenger of Allah, alayhi salatu wasalam, he used to wear a ring on his finger, of which the stone had engraved on it three lines, of which said, Muhammad Rasul Allah. Muhammadur Rasulullah. Muhammad was on the lowest line, and the name of our Lord, Tabarak wa Ta'ala, it was on the highest line. And this was the ring of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he used to place the stamp or his seal on the letters that he sent to the disbelievers when he called them to this religion of Al-Islam, to the deen of La ilaha illallah. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his legs were like tree trunks, alayhi salatu wa salam, of which he used to wear his lower garment halfway up his calf, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. The Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam, he had wide feet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which were also large, and he used to walk quite quickly, alayhi salatu wa sallam. And lastly, we describe the mouth of the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as he had a wide mouth, alayhi salatu wa sallam. So wide that when he smiled, his face lit up, and you can see his back teeth, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the teeth of the Messenger of Allah, alayhi salatu wa sallam, were beautiful and white, and he had a gap in between his two front teeth, two upper front teeth, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. When the Messenger of Allah, alayhi salatu wa sallam, used to speak, his voice used to seem a little on the horsey side, alayhi salatu wa sallam. And when he recited the Quran, they said, we never heard a voice more pleasant than the voice of the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. When he talked, alayhi salatu wa sallam, whoever wanted to count the number of words that he used in any sentence, they would be able to count the words that he used, alayhi salatu wa sallam, because he didn't speak very fast, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rather, he spoke very distinct and very clearly, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so much so that anyone who sat near him memorized whatever he said. And this is a brief description of our Prophet and Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of which we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us to be amongst those who the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in the hadith that we began with, من رآني في المنام فسيراني في يقظة. Whoever sees me in a dream will see me while he is awake. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us with the sight of our Prophet and Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. O Allah, we ask you to give us and to increase us in iman. Oh Allah, we ask you to increase us in iman with the recitation of the Quran. Oh Allah, we ask you to increase us in knowledge, to increase us in taqwa, to increase us in wealth, to increase us in strength, to increase us in numbers. Oh Allah, we ask you to make us victorious over the disbelieving people. Oh Allah, we ask you for Jannah. Oh Allah, we ask you for Jannah. Oh Allah, we ask you for Jannah. And to save us from the fire. Oh Allah, save us from the fire. Oh Allah, save us from the fire. Oh Allah, give us the good in this world and the good in the hereafter, and save us from the fire.